Hi guys, if the videos are affording you the opportunity to study at any time, at any place, and at any pace, and from any device that you have, then we are giving you real convenience. So then don't forget to subscribe. You can even like, you can even share, and you can even comment. And it is my hope that we are giving you what you are liking on your favorite channel of real convenience, Telecom Akan. Welcome. Welcome to Telecom Academy. As usual, your presenter is Motion Marufu, and my email address motionmarufu60@gmail.com. On WhatsApp, +26317135866. And I'm bringing you junction field effect transistors. And I hope you are going to enjoy. Objectives. You guys, by the end of the presentation, you should be able to, number one, define field effect transistor and list its three terminals, just as we did for BJT transistor and its three terminals. Must be able to list the types of field effect transistors. Then number three, compare bipolar junction transistor to field effect transistors. We have covered BJT, so you must be able to compare and contrast BJT and FETs. Then number four, you must be able to explain how junction field effect transistor is constructed, its operation, and also its characteristics. Number five, you must be able to explain the relationship between junction field effect channel width and its drain currents, and also the relationship between gate to source voltage VGS and also the drain current. Then the other objective, you must be able to describe the gate input impedance characteristics of the junction field effect transistor. Then last but not least, you must be able to list and define commonly used JFET parameters and their ratings. Quite a number of objectives, but I know you'll be able to do all that is listed. Basically, we have two types of transistors, bipolar junction transistor and field effect transistor. And there are two types of field effect transistors, the junction field effect transistor, in short JFET, and the metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, in short MOSFET. The operating principles of these two transistors are not the same, just their applications and also their limitations vary. In this video presentation, we are going to look at junction field effect transistors, their circuits, and we'll cover MOSFETs in another separate lecture ahead. The junction field effect transistor, abbreviated JFET or simply FET, is another semiconductor device just like bipolar junction transistor. It can also be used as an amplifier and as a switch. The JFET has got three terminals just like the bipolar junction transistor, and these three terminals are known as the gate, the drain, and the source. The gate, the symbol is capital letter G, drain symbol is capital letter D, and the source, the symbol is capital letter S. The controlling terminal is the gate terminal. So please take note of the three terminals of a JFET transistor or a FET transistor. These are gate, drain, and source. Junction field effect transistor construction, in short JFET. In this slide, we are going to look at the construction of junction field effect transistor, and we've got two types of JFET, P channel as well as N channel. This is our P channel and this is our N channel, hence the name P channel as well as N channel. We saw that a BJT has three separate terminals, either two type materials and a single P channel material, or two P-type materials and an N-type material sandwiched between the two. JFET only has two materials, a single N-type material and a single P-type material. This is our P-type material and this is our single type N-type material. Please take note that we are calling it single Y because these two are joined together and they are internally joined. This is made up of this P-channel and we are referring this to as one P-type material and one type N material. The channel, the channel is labeled, and this is our drain, this is our gate, and this is our source. The drain, the gate, and the source. So we've got three terminals that make up the field effect transistor, the drain, the gate, and the source, both for a P-channel as well as for an N channel. Differences between bipolar junction transistor and field effect transistor. This diagram is showing a current control device. In other words, it is showing a bipolar junction transistor and this is showing a field effect transistor. And BJT is current controlled. What are we saying? We are saying the input is the controlling current and the output is the controlled current. And we are saying collector current is the controlled current and the controlling element is the base current. For a voltage control device, we are saying the controlling voltage is gate to source voltage and the controlled element is the output current, which is the drain current. So we are saying gate to source voltage VGS controls the drain current. The input current base current controls the output current, which is the collector current. So the difference is, or being highlighted, is BJT is a current operated device while is a voltage controlled device. The BJT is current controlled because output current, which is the collector current, is controlled by varying the input current, which is the base current. The field effect transistor is a voltage controlled device because the input voltage, which is the gate to source voltage, controls the output current, which is the drain current. The second difference between BJT and FET is that FET is a unipolar while BJT is a bipolar, even from the name bipolar. Unipolar simply means current is due to either walls or electrons and never through both, while BJT is bipolar, meaning a current flow is due to both walls and electrons. And just as there are NPN and PNP transistors, field effect transistor AF got P channel as well as N channel types. Then the other difference between BJT and field effect transistor is that BJT has got a very low input impedance while field effect transistors have got a very high input impedance. And the input impedance of FET runs from 1 to several mega ohm and it is much higher than the input resistance of the bipolar junction transistors. The fourth difference between BJT and FET is that field effect transistors are more temperature stable when compared to BJT. That is to say, in FET or in field effect transistors, as we increase the temperature, drain resistance also increases, thus reducing drain current. Thus, unlike bipolar junction transistors, it means thermal runaway does not occur in field effect transistors. So we can safely say field effect transistors is more temperature stable, because in BJT, when we increase temperature, we increase the collector current. But in FET, as temperature increases, we know there is an increase in the drain resistance. So it means that drain current is reduced instead of being increased. Then the other difference between BJT and FET is that FET requires less space when we compare them to bipolar junction transistors, and this makes them ideal for use in integrated circuit. This is a N-channel junction field effect transistor, while this is a P-channel junction field effect transistor. As you can see, this is our P-channel, hence labeled P, and this is our N-channel, hence N. And we said the three terminals that make up a field effect transistor are the drain, the gate, and the source. This is our source. And as I said, the P-type materials are joined together, hence we are referring it to as one, because they are internally joined together, and these are what are called the ohmic contacts. They allow us to connect some wires to the transistor. This is the symbol of N channel. As you can see, the arrow is pointing in for an N channel junction field effect transistor. Don't forget the enclosure, which is the circle. So we've got the drain, the gate, and the source. We don't have the base, the collector, and emitter in field effect transistors. This is a P-channel. As you can see, the P-type material, it stretches from the drain to the source. These are the ohmic contacts, the black, and they allow us to connect the wires or the leads to the transistor. The gate, the N-channel and the P-channel are joined together by this wire, so they are internally joined together. Then, as we said, It has got three terminals, the drain, the gate, and the source end. This is the simple end for a P-channel. The arrow is pointing upwards. The drain, the gate, and the source. Make sure you are able to draw the construction diagram for both the N-channel and the P-channel, and take note of the schematic symbol for each. For an N-channel junction field effect transistor, the arrow points in, and for a P-N-channel, the arrow points outwards. And please take note that it doesn't matter. The arrow can be at the center. It can be anywhere along the gate. Like in this case, it is downward. And also for a P-channel, the arrow need not to be at the center. As we saw under BJT, the arrow points towards the N-type material. In JFET, when the arrow is pointing in, we know it is pointing towards the channel. That's for Fig A in the previous slide. It is the schematic symbol for an N-channel JFET. And when the arrow is pointing out, we can view it as pointing towards the gate. So it means if the gate is an N-type material, the channel must be a P-type material, because the arrow always points towards the any type. Thus, we can safely say Fig B is the schematic symbol for a P-channel JFET. And please take note this tricky. Just think N for in. This will remind you that the N-channel JFET, which is this N, is the arrow pointing in. So this N for any channel means the arrow must point in if you want to memorize the schematic symbol. And just like in BJT, we have got a positive supply as well as a negative supply voltage, and the same relationship that applies in BJT also applies in JFET. So we know that, or we will see that, N-channel JFET require positive supply while P-channel require a negative supply. And let's see in the next slide the two supply voltages for the N as well as for the P-channel field effect transistors. N-channel junction field effect transistor operation. We saw that when we were studying bipolar junction transistors, we were normally concentrating on NPN transistor, and we said the only difference between the operation of NPN and PNP transistor was in the direction of current as well as in the supply voltage. That is, the only differences were the voltage polarities as well as the current directions. And we'll follow the same principle in field effect transistors. We'll be talking of the N-channel JFET, but we know that the only difference between N-channel and P-channel is in the voltage polarity as well as in the current direction. The way how a junction field effect transistor operates is based on varying the width of the channel. And if we vary the width of the channel, we are controlling the drain current, and we know that from factor that affect resistance. If we decrease the width, we are increasing its resistance, meaning we are reducing the drain current. So let's proceed to the next figure and see the following: that the drain to source voltage generates current through the JFET, and if we assume it to be constant, it means that we can decrease the drain current if we increase the resistance of the channel. And how can we increase or the resistance of the channel? We decrease its width, and this is true if we consider R is equal to rho L divided by the cross-sectional area A. Let us proceed. The supply voltages for the N-channel as well as for the P-channel, I said for an N-channel, the member N for in. So this is an N-channel junction field effect transistor, and this is a P-channel junction field effect transistor. And we say N-channel needs a positive supply voltage, which is plus VDD, while a P-channel requires a negative supply voltage, which is minus VDD. So this is our drain resistor RD, our source resistor RS, and our gate resistor RG. And please take note that because this is positive, drain current flows downwards through RD, and because the eighth is more positive than the negative VDD, it means that our drain current flows towards the supply voltage minus VDD. More on N-channel junction field effect transistor construction. As we saw, this is an N-channel. This is our channel, and we can imagine it as the material between the two P-type material. In this case, it can also be P-channel sandwiched between the two N-type material. But please take note that, as I said in the first slide on, these two are joined together, hence we regard them as one P-type material. And please take note that they are joined through this wire. And then we have the gate terminal coming out where the two meet. And we are saying the structure of any channel, as it is shown above, these are what we call the ohmic contacts is labeled. This is our drain, this is our gate, and this is our source. And we are saying the channel existed between the drain and the source. And please take note that it is pointing in on the schematic symbol. We are saying a semiconductor bar of N-type material. This is the semiconductor bar of N-type material. And the ohmic contacts are made to the ends. These are the ohmic contacts. They are made to the end of the N-type bar. And as I said, the terminals are labeled drain, source, and gate. So at the end of the bar, we have got the drain and the source. And on both sides of the bar, in this case, the N-type bar, we have got heavily doped P regions. And this becomes a PN junction, and this also becomes a PN junction. Hence, we can say we've got two PN junctions. And we are saying the supply voltage is connected between the drain and the source, and we call it VDS, drain to source voltage. And it is this which causes the current to flow through the length material of the N-type. Since this is an N-type, we can safely say the drain current is due to electrons, which are the majority charge carriers. And we are saying this is the direction of conventional flow of current, which points in, which means towards the N-type material. N-channel junction field effect transistor. Let's now discuss the channel for N-type material. And we are saying it is made up of N-type material, and it can be seen to be sandwiched between two P-type gate materials, though the two are regarded as one since they are joined together. And we are saying majority charge carriers for an N-type channel are electrons, and they move this channel from the drain to the source. And since the channel is an N-type material, this field effect transistor is called N-channel junction field effect transistor. The properties of the channel. 1. The channel width reduces with the gate to source voltage. You will see that the gate to source voltage is meant to reduce the channel width when it is connected to the N-channel junction field effect transistor, or even to the P-channel junction field effect transistor. And in the saturation region, or when the transistor is operating in the saturation region, the channel width will be constant, and the only resistance of the JFET depends on its length as well as on the width of the channel. These are the characteristics of a JFET channel. P-channel junction field effect transistor, the construction diagram as well as the schematic symbol. And for a P-type, or for a P-channel JFET, the arrow points outwards from the P-type to the N-type gate, and the material in between the drain and the source is the P-channel material, and it is sandwiched between two N-type material that make up the gates. And we say these are the ohmic contacts that allow us to connect the gate, which is the wire, as well as the drain and the source. And we are saying the only difference between N-channel and P-channel is that a P-type semiconductor bar is sandwiched between 2P2 N-type gate regions. For an N-channel, an N-type material is sandwiched between 2P-type regions. And the current flow in a P-type material is due to walls, since the channel is a P-type material, whereas in an N-type material, current flow is due to electrons, since the channel is of N-type. Voltage polarities and current directions for N-type and P-type junction field effect transistor. We said for an N-channel, VGS must be positive and VGS must be negative. As we can see, VGS, this is the negative terminal, this is the positive terminal. VDS, drain to source voltage, gate to source voltage. For an N-channel, drain to source voltage is positive, hence this P and the negative A. For a P-channel junction field effect transistor, VDS is negative, hence we've got a negative polarity and a positive polarity there. And gate to source voltage, we have got the voltage at the gate terminal as positive with respect to the voltage at the source. Hence, for in any channel, drain current is flowing in this direction and gate current is flowing in that direction. For a P channel, drain current is flowing in the upward direction and the gate current is flowing in that direction. But take note that gate current IG is equal to zero. And please take note that because gate current is equal to zero, it means that drain current is equal to source current. The same applies, source current is equal to drain current, because you see that because the gate to source junction is reverse biased, you will see that gate current is equal to zero. Please take note that the arrow is pointing in for any channel and it is pointing outwards for a P channel. Hence, go through the literature. VDS is positive and VGS is negative for any channel, and the opposite is true. They are saying the conventional direction of drain current is from drain to the source, and this is for any channel. The second diagram shows the same for P channel material, and the voltages are opposite to that of any channel, and conventional direction of current is from source to the drain. And for both two types of junction field effect transistor, gate current is equal to zero. Why? Because you will see that the gate to source junction is always reverse biased for the proper operation of the junction field effect transistor. Let us proceed. If you haven't subscribed, don't hesitate to hit the subscribe button. It's you. You know what that means. The relationship between channel width and drain current. We've got three diameters for the three conductors X, Y, and Z, and this one has got the highest diameter, this one has got the smallest diameter. So we want to find the relationship between the diameter and resistance. We know that R is equal to rho L divided by A. So we are saying the resistance of the conductor, of this conductor, which is Rx, it is less than that of Ry, and it is also, this resistance of Ry is less than that of Rz. Why? Because this has got the most resistance, followed by this, and this one has got the least resistance. So we are saying, the smaller the diameter of a conductor, the more resistance it has. Therefore, Rx is less than Ry and it is less than equal to Rz. And this was the relationship between conductor width and resistance. Let's have a look at diagram B. And in diagram B, we only have got drain to source voltage, and we are saying it is the drain to source voltage that generates a current through the junction field effect transistor. And this is any type. But normally, this circuit does not work with only one supply voltage. We need gate to source voltage as shown in or on C. And this is our gate to source voltage. And please take note that this is our negative and it is connected to the P-type material. And this is our positive and it is connected to the N-type material. Hence, we can safely say this P-N junction is reverse biased, hence the increase in the depletion layer, to the effect that if we continue to increase gate to source voltage, this channel is going to or close owing to the reverse bias between this channel as well as this channel, or this junction and this junction. So we can say the gate to source voltage VGS reduces the channel width. Why? Because this, we've got P-type material and this is reverse biased, so the depletion region is going to increase. The depletion region is going to increase towards the channel, hence the channel width is going to decrease. So we are saying the width of the channel can be increased by applying a reverse bias gate to source voltage to the gate to source junction. Gate to source junction, gate to source junction, as shown in C. The negative terminal of VGS is connected to the P-type material, while the positive terminal is connected to the N-type material as well. This connection reverse biases the gate-to-source junction, causing a depletion region to form. So we have two depletion regions forming, this depletion region and also this depletion region, to to the effect that if we continue to increase gate to source voltage, the two are going to meet and they are going to allow negligible current flow through the channel, because the channel has become thin and thin and thin. So we know that a depletion layer acts as an insulator, thus the cross-sectional area of the channel is effectively reduced when a depletion layer is formed, causing drain current T to reduce. More on the relationship between the channel width and drain current. Please take note, there are two ways in which we can control the channel width. This is the width of our channel from there to there, from there to there, from there to there. And as you can see, as we are increasing gate to source voltage from 0 to around minus 4, the channel width is decreasing due to increase in the depletion regions towards each other, to the effect that our drain current will be equal to 0 when the two depletion regions meet, meaning that there is no channel existing between the two P-type material. So we are saying if we vary the gate to source voltage, we vary the width of the channel, and this means that we'll be varying the drain current as shown. So please take note, you must be able to illustrate the relationship between gate to source voltage and drain current. We are simply saying if the gate to source voltage is 0, it's minus 1, it's minus 2, it's minus 4, and we are increasing it, and the channel width is decreasing, meaning the drain current is also decreasing, because the width of the channel determines drain current, and the thinner the channel, the less the drain current. So we are saying as gate to source voltage increases, so does the width of the depletion layers, and as the size of the depletion layer increases, this reduces the effective width of the channel, and as the effective width of the channel decreases, so does the drain current. So we can safely say the relationship between gate to source voltage and drain current can be summarized as gate to source voltage increases, that is becoming more negative, drain current decreases. Please, this is the summary of what we are saying in this diagram. We can also vary the width of the channel by varying the drain to source voltage. And from the diagram, we can see that our gate to source voltage has been kept constant at 0, because the gate and the source are joined together, hence VGS is equal to 0, and we are varying drain to source voltage from 1 to 4. And we are seeing the effect of increasing the drain to source voltage, and the effect is that the channel width is decreasing. And why is the channel decreasing? Because we are saying this channel, this PN junction, has got a depletion region due to this voltage, and also this N-type junction is a depletion region due to this voltage. As we increase this voltage, we are increasing the depletion regions, these two depletion regions, hence we are reducing the channel as we are increasing the drain to source voltage. So we can safely say the other method of varying the channel width is by varying drain to source voltage, and the higher the drain to source voltage, the smaller the channel width. Please take note that this is for an N-type material. For a P-type material, this will be negative and not positive. Please take note. So we are saying VGS is 0, and we are saying since P-type gate is more negative, we are saying this P-type gate is more negative. Why? Because it is connected to the negative terminal. Hence, we are saying it is reverse biased, hence the formation of the depletion region. And we are saying the greater the drain to source voltage, the greater the difference between the source and the drain, and the larger the depletion layer, meaning the smaller the channel width. So we are saying the second method of increasing the depletion layer or of reducing the channel width is to hold VGS constant while we increase drain to source voltage, as shown. The relationship between channel width and drain current. They seem to be a contradiction, and this is the following contradiction. It seems that increasing the size of the depletion layer would increase the resistance of the channel, preventing drain current from increasing. The following question arises. How is it that drain current increases when the resistance of the junction field effect transistor channel is also increasing? And the explanation is, while the resistance distance of the channel is increasing. It is doing that at a slower rate when compared to the increase in drain to source voltage. That is to say, drain source to source voltage is increasing in value faster than the resistance of the channel, hence increase in drain current. As a result, drain current increases as we increase drain to source voltage. There is a point that is going to be reached where further increase in drain to source voltage is offset by proportional increase in the resistance of the channel, and the value of drain to source voltage at which this occurs is called pinch off voltage, VP, and any increase of drain to source voltage beyond pinch off voltage results in the leveling of drain current, that is, it becomes constant. How do you define pinch off voltage, VP? This is the value of drain to source voltage that allows maximum JFET current measured at 0 volts, and this 0 volts refers to gate to source voltage. Fig A shows the relationship between drain to source voltage and drain current, and we are saying when we increase the drain to source voltage, a point is going to be reached when the drain to source voltage causes the leveling off of the drain current. In other words, it remains constant, and we are saying the voltage at which this occurs, according to this diagram, is 5 volts, and we say pinch off voltage is equal to 5 volts, meaning drain current levels, and the maximum drain current at which this occurs is called IDSS. And we are saying when we increase the drain to source voltage from 0 up to the pinch off voltage, there is a proportional increase in drain current. Hence, we say the transistor is operating in the ohmic region. But when we reach the pinch off voltage, we are going to have a constant current flow of drain current. In other words, we call this the constant current region. And when there is now a sudden increase in drain current, for any increase in drain to source voltage, we have reached the breakdown voltage as shown. We now have a sharp increase in drain current. So these measurements are done at a gate to source voltage of 0 volts. But for varying gate to source voltage from 0 to minus 5, we are seeing the change in the drain current. In other words, if we continue to increase but in the negative direction, the gate to source voltage, we are going to have a decrease in the drain current, but that does not change the pinch off voltage as well as the breakdown voltage. So this is the measure. This is a graph of drain to source voltage against drain current for different values of gate to source voltage, and we call this junction field effect transistor drain curves, since they show drain current. Explanation of the drain curve, and we are saying the portion to the left of the pinch off voltage is referred to as the ohmic region, and we are saying as far as the drain to source voltage, or as the drain to source voltage increases from 0 to the pinch off voltage, we are having an increase in drain current, and if drain to source voltage reaches VP, we are going to have a leveling off of drain current, and it remains constant for all values of drain to source voltage between VP and the breakdown voltage, VBR. The region where this occurs is called the constant current region, and as long as our drain to source voltage is kept within this range, we have a constant drain current or a constant value of gate to source voltage. And when VGS equals to 0, we essentially have the gate and the source shorted together, and our drain current is going to reach a maximum value of IDSS, and this is referred to as shorted gate to drain current, and it is the maximum possible value of drain current. Any value of JFET drain current must be less than or equal to drain to IDSS, which is shorted gate drain current. And the relationship between VGS, VDS and IDSS is shown in B of the previous slide. And when VGS is close to 0, drain current is close to shorted gate drain current, IDSS. And as we make gate to source voltage more negative than the 0 volts, the drain pinches off at a voltage less than VP, and drain current decreases from the value of IDSS. More on junction field effect transistor drain curves, and we are saying as we make gate to source voltage more negative, we are going to reach a point where the depletion layer effectively seals off the channel. And when this is occurred, we are going to have minimum drain current flowing through the junction field effect transistor. The value of gate to source voltage, which reduces our drain current to zero, is referred to as gate to source cutoff voltage, which means gate to source cutoff voltage. This voltage reduces drain current to zero, and its value defines the limit on the gate to source voltage. And we are saying for conduction to occur through the JFET channel, the value of gate to source voltage must always be less than gate to source voltage off, which means cutoff gate to source voltage, cutoff gate to source voltage. And let's take note of the interesting point that a cutoff gate to source voltage is the same magnitude as pinch off voltage. For example, if VP is 8 volts, then VGS or cutoff gate to source voltage is minus 8. And since these two values are equal and opposite, only one is usually listed on the specification sheet of a given junction field effect transistor. Unbiased junction field effect transistor, meaning VGS, there is no VGS connected. In other words, the control terminal, which is the gate terminal, is left open, and a positive supply is connected to an N-channel JFET between the drain and the source. And we are saying, in an N-type semiconductor, there are a number of electrons that are available for conduction, and they start from the source to the drain under the influence of the drain-to-source voltage, and we call this drain current. And we know that these electrons pass through the narrow passage between the two P-type gates, which is this narrow passage between these two P-type gates, and we call this the channel. And in the absence of the applied voltage, we have got two P-N junction, this P-N junction as well as this P-N junction, and a depletion region gets formed at each junction. We are going to have a depletion region there and a depletion region there, and this is just similar to the depletion region which forms when the P-N junction is not biased. So this is the diagram of an unbiased JFET. Biasing of a gate-to-source junction, and it is biased by gate-to-source voltage VGS. And please take note, the gate-to-source junction for JFET is always reverse biased. This is a very important point which you must take note of, that the gate-to-source junction is always reverse biased. Thus, for an N-channel, VGS is negative, and for a P-channel, VGS is positive. And we saw that if we increase the reverse voltage to the gate-to-source voltage, or the output current which is the drain current, will decrease. And we are saying, due to the reverse bias on the gate-to-source junction, the drain current is negligibly small. In the first slides of this presentation, we saw that drain current was almost equal to source current. Why? Because our gate current is almost equal to zero. Why? We know that no current flows through a reverse bias P-N junction. So we are saying, positive voltage is applied between the drain and the source terminals. So VDS is positive for an N channel and negative for a P channel. This is an operation of an N-channel JFET when the gate-to-source voltage is equal to zero. And we are saying, why is it zero? Because the gate is connected to the source or shorted to the source, making VGS equal to zero. And we are saying it is the drain-to-source voltage that causes a current to flow. And that current is solely due to the resistance of the channel between the drain and the source. And we are saying the channel has got some infinity resistance, meaning that drain-to-source current flow causes a voltage drop across the channel. This reverse voltage will reverse bias the gate-to-source P-N junction, and the depletion region starts forming and penetrates more deeply into the N-type bar because it is slightly doped when compared to the P-type gate. Hence, the penetration of the depletion region into the N-type bar depends on the magnitude of the reverse voltage applied, which means magnitude of the gate-to-source voltage. And we say, due to the depression region, the width of the channel available conduction is reduced if we increase it to source voltage, but in this case it is equal to till on operation of any channel J fed with VGS is equal to zero, and this time we are looking at source saturation current. This source saturation current is also known as the shorted drain to source current, and it is the maximum value of drain current that flows when VGS is equal to zero. It is also known as the source saturation current, and we said it corresponds to the maximum drain current. Why? Because the channel is widest when VGS is equal to zero. Only that insofar as source saturation current is concerned, IDSS. If we increase the gate to source voltage to a small negative value from zero, we are going to see the following changes. That is, we are going to apply a negative voltage between the gate and the source. This is going to allow us to reverse bias the gate to source junction. And when it is reverse biased, it means that we are going to have the formation of the depletion region into the n-type material. And this is going to reduce the channel width further, because we've got two depletion regions that are going to form. And when the depletion regions increase towards each other, it means that the channel width is going to reduce, meaning that we are going to have a reduced drain current. So we are saying drain current reduces with an increase in negative gate to source voltage, and this is only for any channel JFET. For a P channel, drain current reduces with an increase in the positive gate to source voltage, because the gate to source junction must always be reverse biased to the effect that gate current is equal to zero. This time we are going to increase the gate to source voltage to a large value. Please take note in the negative direction for any channel. If we are doing that for a P channel, we are going to increase it in the positive direction. And we are saying, as we increase negative gate to source voltage, we are going to have the depletion region spread more into the n-type bar. And at a certain value of gate to source voltage, the two depletion regions are going to touch, meaning they are going to reduce the drain current to zero. And this gate to source voltage is called cutoff gate to source voltage. And if we increase in the negative direction gate to source voltage, the channel becomes more and more narrow, thus reducing drain current as shown to ID equals to zero. And for a gate to source voltage of zero, we have got maximum drain current, which is IDSS, that flows through the JFET, as we saw when VGS was equal to 0 volts. A cut-off gate-to-source voltage, in brackets, cut-off gate-to-source voltage. And we are saying the value of gate-to-source voltage that makes the drain current almost equal to zero is this voltage, or the cut-off gate-to-source voltage, in brackets, cut-off gate-to-source voltage. And we are saying this is the value of gate source voltage that makes the drain current almost equal to zero, and it is denoted as VGS off as shown. And we are saying a JFET must be operated between gate source voltage of zero and a cutoff gate to source voltage. And for this, ID will range from zero to the saturation current IDSS. What is the pinch off condition? The pinch off condition is the value of drain to source voltage beyond which the value of drain current remains almost constant at ID is equal to IDSS. And VP is defined always when gate to source voltage is equal to zero. Please take note and don't forget to subscribe. A drain curve for gate to source voltage of zero. And we are saying this is a graph of drain to source voltage against drain current, and we are saying the maximum value of drain current when drain to source voltage is equal to pinch off voltage is called IDSS, and this is the saturation value. And we are saying when VDS is equal to pinch off voltage, we are going to have leveling off of the drain current. Its saturation level for VGS is equal to 0 volts, but this is what for the ohmic region. And we are saying there is an increase in drain current for an increase in drain to source voltage. Then when we reach a breakdown voltage, that's when we are going to have an increase, a rapid increase in train current, for an increase in, or when we rather reach the breakdown voltage. So we are saying this is ID versus drain to source voltage for VGS is equal to 0 volts. We've come to the end of introduction to junction field effect transistors, and I hope guys you have enjoyed and you have learned something. In our next video, we'll be looking at JFET connection configurations, common source, common drain and common gate, and we'll be doing what we did when we looked at the JT connection configurations. We'll also be looking at the JFET parameters, transconductance and some other JFET parameters. Guys, if you haven't subscribed, don't be afraid. Don't hesitate to hit the subscribe button. But if you have done so, thank you for your support. It is you who make Telecom Academy great.